families who've lost their loved ones, their dear ones. I know this is a different occasion completely, a happy occasion, an occasion to celebrate, but to overcome all those challenges which happened some time ago, it would not have happened without the spirit and resilience of Keralites. Kerala is back on its feet again, and I can tell you from whatever I've experienced, I've played cricket here, and whatever I experienced, the kind of support and passion, I know even for this CBL, Keralites are extremely passionate about it, and those are the things which allow you to get back on your feet faster than other occasions. And here, I would like to applaud the organizers, all the committee members, for putting up this event in just about 20 days, because this event was originally planned on the 10th of August, and literally we are 20 days later celebrating at the launch of CBL. So big congratulations to all the committee members and organizers. When we talk about boat race in whichever part of the world, the first name comes to our mind is Kerala. And I think it is lot to do with our forefathers, our ancestors, the tradition and the culture of Kerala, which has been so strong. It has left their impression behind with us, and we take so much joy in celebrating these special moments. So I feel India has been a sports loving nation, but we very seldom ourselves go out and play. So the biggest transformation as a sportsman I would want is India to become a sports playing nation from a sports loving nation. And here is a great example, because not just men, but I also saw women rowing here. I'm particularly wanting to express this because the tendency is my little boy can go out and play while the little girl stays at home and helps her mother do all the household work. I think it is equally important for them to go out and play some sport, live their childhood to its fullest. And I think when it comes to sport, especially team sport, it teaches you so many things in life. It teaches you about playing together, sacrificing for each other. I'm particularly talking here about women, because women are the backbone of any family. If women are healthy, physically fit and mentally fit, the house is happy. And here I'm particularly asking everyone to adopt some sport, not just cricket. I have not come here as a cricketer. I've come here as a sportsman who enjoys all sports. It really doesn't matter which sport you play, but make an effort to play sport, lead a healthy and fit lifestyle. In India, in the recent past, we have noticed that transformation is taking place from a sports loving nation to sports playing nation, and there are a number of new leagues been introduced. And I'm so happy because we've slowly started reaping results of that. It's not going to happen overnight. It's a lengthy process, one has to stay committed, one has to be dedicated, disciplined, and there is a lot of hard work which goes behind a successful athlete. I know everyone wants to win here. My message to all the teams which are participating is plan, prepare yourself, practice hard, and then go out and execute those plans. Not everyone can go out and win, but don't cheat to win. Don't find shortcuts, because sport is something which has taught me that even if you lose, you get back on your feet again and start competing in the fairest possible manner. When it comes to comparing the boat racing and cricket, for us it is 66 feet. I've learnt a lot about boat racing and the boats, the length of the boat. For us, the pitch is 66 feet. For the boat racing, their guys, their boat varies between 95 to 100 feet. Our team maximum goes to 15, 16 players sitting in the dressing room. When it comes to coordination, it's about 95 to 105 rowing players in the team. I think that requires a lot of understanding between the team. And I applaud all these participants because none of them are professional athletes. It's the love and passion for this sport which has allowed them to come together, practice for a month, month and a half, and here they are competing in front of us. It has not just allowed them to live their passion, but also their livelihood. Number of guys are jobless, they've got a job, there is some earning from this, and I feel along with getting fit, if you can find an employment and look after your family, it is a great initiative by all the organizers here, all the associates, sponsors who've backed this. I want to applaud their effort. When it comes to keeping India clean, we all have heard about Swachh Bharat movement. But when it comes to Swachh Bharat movement, we only talk about the land. We've got beautiful water bodies which can be maintained. And without any doubt, when you come to Kerala, you see such wonderful water bodies. The experience is everlasting. I'm sure this league will inspire many to start their own leagues, and there'll be more employment, more enthusiasm, more excitement within the fans. I want to also congratulate tourism here, because I think with all these activities, tourism in Kerala is going to go to a new level. And if we keep our water bodies clean, it is going to attract even more tourists. I want to congratulate all the teams and wish them all the very best for the season, which goes on for 3 months. Play in the right spirit, enjoy this atmosphere, and thank you once again for living such wonderful memories with me. There's something that I've all experienced coming to Kerala. I look forward to my next trip to Kerala. Nanni Namaskaram.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your wonderful and inspiring words. It's a pleasure to have you here. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much once again. And now is the presentation of memento to Sri Pinarayi Vijayan, Honorable Chief Minister of Kerala, by Advocate AMR, Member of Parliament. Bahumanapetta Mukhyamantrikku Snehobaharam Nalgugayana, പാർലമെന്റ് അംഗമായ അഡ്വക്കേറ്റ് എ എം ആരിഫ്. Next is the presentation of Momentum to Sri Sachin Tendulkar by the Nehru Trophy Boat Race Society Secretary Sri Krishna Teja IAS and Tourism Director Sri Balakiran IAS. അടുത്തതായി ചടങ്ങിൽ എത്തിച്ചേർന്നവരോടുള്ള നന്ദി പ്രകാശിപ്പിക്കുന്നതിനു വേണ്ടി നന്ദിയിലേക്ക് കടക്കുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് ആലപ്പുഴ മുനിസിപ്പൽ ചെയർമാൻ ബഹുമാനപ്പെട്ട മുഖ്യമന്ത്രിക്ക് സ്നേഹോപഹാരം നൽകുകയാണ്. വോട്ട് ഓഫ് താങ്ക്സിന് വേണ്ടി ശ്രീ പി ബാലകിരൺ ഐഎഎസിനെ ക്ഷണിക്കുന്നു ഡയറക്ടർ ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് ഓഫ് ടൂറിസം.
ഹലോ, ഓണറബിൾ ചീഫ് മിനിസ്റ്റർ ശ്രീ പിണറായി വിജയൻ സർ, റെസ്പെക്റ്റഡ് പ്രസിഡന്റ് ഓണറബിൾ ഫിനാൻസ് മിനിസ്റ്റർ ഡോക്ടർ ടി എം തോമസ് ഐസക് സർ, എൻ ടി ബി ആർ സൊസൈറ്റി ഇനോഗ്രേറ്റർ ഓണറബിൾ ടൂറിസം മിനിസ്റ്റർ ശ്രീ കടകംപള്ളി സുരേന്ദ്രൻ സർ, ക്രിക്കറ്റ് ലെജൻഡ് ശ്രീ സച്ചിൻ ടെണ്ടുൽക്കർ, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എ സ്പെക്ടാക്കുലർ ഡേ ഫോർ അസ്. കേരള ഗോഡ്സ് ഓൺ കൺട്രി ഈസ് നോൺ വേൾഡ് ഓവർ ആസ് ദ വേൾഡ് റിനോൺ ടൂറിസം ഡെസ്റ്റിനേഷൻ. ടുഡേ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഗോയിങ് ടു ബി നോൺ ആസ് ഫർ ഇറ്റ്സ് വേൾഡ്സ് ഗ്രേറ്റസ്റ്റ് സ്പോർട്, ദ ഗോഡ്സ് ഓൺ സ്പോർട്, സ്നേക് ബോട്ട് റേസസ്. വി ആർ എക്സ്ട്രീംലി ഹാപ്പി ദറ്റ് ദ സ്നേക് ബോട്ട് റേസസ് ഹാവ് ഓൾറെഡി സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ്. And we think it will take the snake boat races to the world all over. I'll quickly go to my experience of thanking the entire team. First, let me thank Honorable Chief Minister Shri Pinrai Vijayan sir, who has been the backbone for the Champions Boat League.
इंडिया खबर लाइव के दर्शक देख सकते हैं कि अभी कुछ ही देर पहले मास्टर ब्लास्टर सचिन तेंदुलकर ने अपना स्पीच दिया और उन्होंने कहा कि खेल खेलते समय हमें कभी किसी को चीट नहीं करना है और यदि कहीं चूक हुई है तो फिर से एक स्टार्ट की ओर दो हमको अपना रुख करना है और जहां गलती हुई है उसको हमें सुधारना है, इम्प्रूव करके फिर मैदान में आना है. और वहां के सीएम पिनराई विजयन ने सचिन तेंदुलकर जी को वो ट्रॉफी प्रदान की.
हमारे दर्शक देख सकते हैं कि हर कोई ये जो दृश्य है उनको अपने मोबाइल में कैमरे में कैद करना चाहता है और साथ ही देख सकते हैं कि सेल्फी हर कोई सचिन तेंदुलकर साहब के साथ में लेना चाहता है. और ये खूबसूरत नज़ारा इस वक्त 67वीं नेहरू बोट रेस का. कहीं ना कहीं हर एक प्रतियोगिता हमें बहुत कुछ सीखने को सिखाती है, सीखने चाहिए हमें हर एक कंपटीशन से. इस कार्यक्रम में मुख्यमंत्री सचिन तेंदुलकर जी और भी कई दिग्गज हस्तियां इस वक्त यहाँ पर मौजूद है. और इस कार्यक्रम जो कि बोट रेस है इसमें भी कहीं ना कहीं अनुशासन बहुत मायने रखता है हर खिलाड़ी के लिए. कोई भी खेल हो क्रिकेट हो फुटबॉल हो, लेकिन टीम वर्क की भावना टीम हर एक के लिए ज़रूरी है। जब खिलाड़ी यह भावना रखे कि मेरा भी बहुत बड़ा महत्वपूर्ण सहयोग है मेरे इस जीत में, तो कहीं ना कहीं फिर जब इस टीम भावना के साथ में कोई भी खिलाड़ी खेलता है तो निश्चित रूप से वह अपने लक्ष्य तक पहुंचने में कामयाब भी होता है। और इस वक्त बोट रेस के दृश्यों से हमारे दर्शक रूबरू हो रहे हैं। एक बहुत ही सुंदर आयोजन यहाँ पर आज किया गया है। कार्यक्रम का हिंदी ट्रांसलेशन आप इंडिया खबर लाइव स्टूडियो से सुन पा रहे हैं।
Social Street and the TV production unit and all the TV channels who were beaming it live from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. So let me also thank everybody, all the organizers, all the policemen, all the departments, irrigation, everybody, all the tourism department officials, one and all, for making it a grand success. This is only the beginning. Every Saturday, CBL will be coming live onto your TVs, live onto your live races till November 23rd. Thank you very much. I'll also thank the deputy director and entire tourism staff for making it a grand success.
Thank you, sir. Driksachi Varanathinayi, Sri Shaiju Damodaraneyum, Adhekathodoppamulla, Matta Driksachi Varanathinayi, Kshanikkunnu.
ട്രോഫി ജലോത്സവത്തിന്റെ ഫിനിഷിംഗ് ബോട്ടിൽ നിന്ന് ഷാജി ചേരമൻ നൽകുന്ന വിവരണം. എന്നോടൊപ്പം ഷൈജു ദാമോദരൻ, ടി സജി, അജു മേപ്പാടം എന്നിവരുണ്ട്. പ്രാഥമിക മത്സരങ്ങളിൽ ഒന്നാം പാദ മത്സരങ്ങൾ സമാപിച്ചു. ഇനി രണ്ടാം പാദ മത്സരമാണ് ആരംഭിക്കേണ്ടത്. ഒന്നാം ട്രാക്കിലൂടെ കടന്നു വരുന്ന ദേവസ് ചുണ്ടനാണ്. 2011 വിജയിച്ച ദേവസ് ചുണ്ടനെ NCDC ബോട്ട് ക്ലബ്ബ് കൈപ്പിടമുട്ട് ചീഫ് അങ്കൽ ജെഫി ഫിലിക്സ് ആണ് ഇതിനെ നയിക്കുന്നതെങ്കിൽ രണ്ടാം ട്രാക്കിലൂടെ കാരിച്ചാൽ ബോട്ട് ക്ലബ്ബ് കാരിച്ചാൽ ചുണ്ടനാണ്. 14 പ്രാവശ്യക്കാലം നെഹ്റു ട്രോഫിയുടെ ചെങ്കോലും കിരീടവും കരസ്ഥമാക്കിക്കൊണ്ട് 1974 76 2008 2016 2018 നെഹ്റു ട്രോഫി നേടിക്കൊണ്ട് ഈ പുന്നമട ചെയ്ത സാമ്രാജ്യം അടക്കി ഭരിച്ച കാരിച്ചാൽ ചുണ്ടൻ 1982 83 84 ആദ്യത്തെ ഹാട്രിക്കോട് കൂടി കുമരകൻ ടൗൺ ബോട്ട് ക്ലബ്ബ് ജയിച്ചതോളമാണെങ്കിൽ ഇക്കുറി ഇതിനെ കേരള പോലീസ് ടീമാണ് ഇതിനെ നയിക്കുന്നതെങ്കിൽ ദേവേഷ് കുമാർ ബെഹ്റ IPS ആണ് ഇതിന്റെ ക്യാപ്റ്റൻ എങ്കിൽ നാലാം ട്രാക്കിലൂടെ കടന്നു വരുന്നത് മൂന്നാം ട്രാക്കിലൂടെ ഗബ്രിയൽ ചുണ്ടനാണ്. 2017 ജേതാവായ ഗബ്രിയലിനെ വില്ലേജ് ബോട്ട് ക്ലബ്ബ് എടുത്തുവായാണ് ഇതിനെ നയിക്കുന്നതെങ്കിൽ എബ്രഹാം കോശി മൂന്ന് തൈക്കൽ ആണ് ഇതിന്റെ ക്യാപ്റ്റൻ. ഈ 67th നെഹ്റു ട്രോഫി ജലോത്സവത്തിന്റെ പ്രാഥമിക മത്സരങ്ങളിൽ മുൻപ് ഒന്നാമത് നടുഭാഗം ചുണ്ടൻ നല്ലൊരു പ്രകടനം കാഴ്ചവെച്ചുകൊണ്ട് വള്ളപ്പാടുകളുടെ വിജയങ്ങൾ കരസ്ഥമാക്കിക്കൊണ്ട് കടന്നുപോയെങ്കിൽ ഈ 67th നെഹ്റു ട്രോഫി ജലോത്സവത്തിന്റെ ആളും ഒരങ്ങും
Thank you. now the event going on is heats number 2 in the snake boat section. It's a thrilling encounter for Supremacy. Now I can see on the monitor number 9 Karichal this time owned by Police Boat Club, and the captain is Devesh Kumar Behra, IPS Commandant, IRB. And you know, Karichal is a king among the snake boats. It has won the Nehru Trophy in the years 1974, 75, 76, 80, 82, 83, 84, 86, 87, 2000, 2001, 2003, 2008 and 2016. See, Karichal, or is it Devas? Is it Devas? It cannot be predicted. Yes, Karichal, Police Boat Club in track number 2. Karichal, it can be said that Karichal has won the race in the second heat, and it seems that Devas has come second, and you know, Gabriel has come third. This is a replay of the second heats. It cannot be predicted for certain who has won in the second heats in the snake boat section. That always happens in the boat race. Often it becomes a neck and neck kind of for Supremacy. So the official announcement is yet to take place. Now the event going on, or the event about to begin, is heats number 3 in the snake boat section. In the first track, there is race number 7, that is St. George. And in the second track, number 11, Paipadan, holders, St. George, Paipadan and Chambakulam. These boats are names to reckon with in the snake boat section. Chambakulam had won the Nehru Trophy 12 times, including several hat-tricks. Chambakulam, oaring in the third track, was winner in the years 1989, 1991, 94, 95, 96, 98, 2009 and 14. So, like that, Paipadan, last year's winner Paipadan, is this year owned by Kumaragam Town Boat Club. Paipadan had won earlier in the years 2005, 2006, 2007, 2017 and 2018. And St. George, named after a saint, this time owned by Brothers Boat Club Edathuwa, and Thomas Kuti Manandurithil Edathuwa is the captain. St. George snake boat was rebuilt in the year 2014, and the length of the boat is 52¼ feet. So it is definitely a tough encounter. It cannot be predicted, as in several races, who will win. But you know, the boats in the first track and second track, they are competing or vying with each other to reach the finishing point. The other boat is also fighting hard. So several times these boats have won the Nehru Trophy boat race. So it can be said that the euphoria is on, as the mighty snake boats is more than or nearly 100 oarsmen on board, sets the backwaters ablaze at the Punnamada backwaters in Alappuzha. The jubilation is bound to reach its zenith for the fans. Vallangali, as the boat race is called in local lingo, is as thrilling as soccer is to the Latin Americans. Bullfighting is for the Spaniards. For coming back home, Thrissur Puram is for the people there. So, see the scenic beauty of Punnamada, palm-fringed Punnamada Lake. The weather is very sunny now. It was drizzling a few moments ago. Anyway, rain or shine, the people bit by the boat bug, they will be here on the banks of the Punnamada to witness this greatest show on water. Yes, Chambakulam, oaring in the third track, the winner in several times, including several hat-tricks, 12 times winner. This time, Chambakulam, owned by UBC Kainagiri Kuttamangalam, and Saju Jacob Palayil is the captain. See, a tough fight. Where on earth, on water, can you see such a dazzling encounter? That is why it is said that the greatest show on water the greatest team sport. See, it is, here is God's plenty. Champakulam, the famous UBC Kainagiri, he is having a comfortable lead now. Number 24, oaring in the third track, Champakulam. It seems that Champakulam will have a facile win in the third heat in the Nehru Trophy boat race of 2019. UBC Kainagiri, it has won several times, rowing in several boats. See the style of their rowing. There is much difference between the Kuttanadan style, Kollam style, and the Kottayam style. See what a beautiful sight it is. Dazzling sight. The spectators are thrilled. See, see, it is 24-24. A very, very tough fight. UBC is leading. UBC Kainagiri, United Boat Club Kainagiri Kuttamangalam, and owned by Saju Jacob Malayil. Yes, Paipadan, it seems, will come only in the second place. Champakulam has a place in the boat races in Kerala. Yes, in the third heat, Champakulam had a very comfortable win, and you know, it was owned by UBC Kainagiri. Saju Jacob is the captain. The second place post goes to Paipadan holders, that is winner in the last year, owned by Kumaragam Boat Club, and you know, the captain is BJ Ajayan. And naturally, the third place goes to St. George, owned by Brothers Boat Club Bedathwa, and with Thomas Kuti as captain. Yes, though the boat race this year was postponed two times, and it has happened today. And here is God's plenty. See, a jam-packed holiday crowd in the VIP pavilion. There is the Chief Minister. There is Minister Kadagampalli Surendran. There is the local MLA and Minister Dr. Thomas Isaac. And, you know, the chairman of the Nehru Trophy boat race and the district collector, Dr. Adila Abdullah, is also there. I hand over the mic to Dr. Sumi Cherian.
Thank you, Professor Cherian Alexander. Now it's Chundan heats number 4 going on. Actually, the CBL races of the heats have ended, and now we move on to the boats that are participating exclusively in the Nehru Trophy boat race. Now we have the Chundan heats number 4. We have in track 1, Charudana, which is owned by the new Charudana Boat Club, captained by Sri Madhu K. M.M. Nivas. And in track number 2, we have Mahadevigada, owned by Devamada Boat Club Chennagiri, captained by Sri Joy Chen Palakal. In track number 3, we have Sen Pius 10th, owned by the Founders Academy and Charitable Society Mangumba, captained by Sri A.J. Chako Ideadi. It's Chundan heats number 4 going on in the 67th Nehru Trophy boat race. It should be specified that the heats this year, fireworks have happened on water in heats number 1, 2, 3. It was a very tough race because those boats, they are going into the CBL. It is their opening race for the CBL. Now we have Chundan heats number 4. The boat in track number 1, Charudana, owned by the new Charudana Boat Club. It is owned by 700 families of the Charudana village. So if this boat wins the Nehru Trophy, it would be a moment of splendor for the people of Charudana village, I should say. In track number 2, we have Mahadevigada. Mahadevigada was last year's finalist. The boat is yet to win the Nehru Trophy. In track number 3, we have Sen Pius. Sen Pius is also a finalist in the 2014 Nehru Trophy boat race. But these 3 boats are yet to win Nehru Trophy. Heats number 4 is going on in the 67th Nehru Trophy boat race, where 20 snake boats vie with each other for this prestigious title. See the beauty, the rhythm of the oars. I should say that compared to the previous heats, this event, it's going on a bit slow. The boats, I think they will not be finishing as early as the boats in the previous heats. In track number 1, we have Charudana. Track number 2, Mahadevigada. In track number 3, we have St. Pius. Here you can see the boat in track number 2 taking a lead. Mahadevigada is taking a lead now. Mahadevigada is owned by Devamada Boat Club Chennangiri and captained by Sri Joy Chen Palakal. Witnessing the Chundan heats number 4. Boat number 12, St. Pius 10, which is owned by the Founders Academy and Charitable Society Mangomba. St. Pius 10 is now taking a lead in Chundan heats number 4. You see St. Pius 10 now moving on to the finishing line. No other boats are seen in the scenario. You see the track, it extends up to a length of 2000 meters. Now you see Pius 10, St. Pius 10 taking a lead. The boats, they go in a rhythm. The different types of oarsmen, around 90 to 100 oarsmen, they participate under the banner of a single boat club. These oarsmen, it is their rowing style that determines whether the boat wins or loses. You see the typical rowing style, the Kuttanadan rowing style, that's what you call, you pick and leave. The boat in track number 3, St. Pius 10, it has won Chundan heats number 4. Let us see who comes in the second position in Chundan heats number 4. No other boats are seen, there is a long time gap. Boat number 6 in track number 1, Charudana. Charudana, which is owned by the new Charudana Boat Club Ayaparamba and captained by Sri Madhu KM. The boat is slowly moving towards, I should say it's slowly moving towards the finishing point. One should say that there is a clear disparity between the club-sponsored boats and the non-sponsored boats. This time the difference is evident. We don't know the finishing time. We are yet awaiting for the precise time in which the boats finished. Number 6, Charudana, in track number 1. It has finished in the second position in Chundan heats number 4. Now we see a replay of the finishing in slow motion. You see St. Pius 10 in track number 3 finishing first in Chundan heats number 4. Earlier there was a drizzle, especially during the mass drill and all. People were a bit worried whether the event would experience any sort of difficulties to be conducted, but now the weather is quite sunny. One should say that the weather should be fine for the smooth conduct of the race, because the velocity of the boats, it will be affected tremendously if the oarsmen are to encounter the rain and then to oar the boat and lead it to the finishing points. Now the weather is fine, sunny, windy. Now you get a view of the Nehru Pavilion. The Nehru Pavilion was built later in memory of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India, who was incidental in beginning this race. It was his enthusiasm that in the first place led to the commencement of such a beautiful and such a big event, the largest water sport on water. You see the crowd. It is in fact a crowd's affair, Nehru Trophy boat race. Unlike any other organized sports event in the world, here it is a crowd that takes up the event. For the villages of Kuttanad, their boat, or the boat that bears their village's name or the club in which their relatives or friends are members, if that boat wins the trophy, it is something that is to be cherished for a lifetime. Now I hand over the mic to Mr. Vivek Menon to give a description of Chundan Heats number 5.
Thank you, Dr. Sumi Chirayan. Now we are going to witness the heat number 5. The race has started. The battle has started. We can see there was some issue, it seems. There was some foul happened, it seems. So let's wait what's going to happen. The referee has interfered. So there was a starting foul, so the referee has to restart the heat number 5. So far we have witnessed the 4 heats. In each heat there were 3 boats, snake boats. But in the heat number 5, we have 4 boats. In track number 1 is Karuvatta Chundan. In track number 2 is Sri Ganeshan. In track number 3, Mahadevan. In track number 4, Jawahar Tayangari. The scenic beauty of Kuttanad. This area is actually below the sea level, where the farmers do the farming activities. Here in most of the houses, they own their own small boats for the transportation purpose. In the cities, it's like people own the cars or vehicles. Here in Kuttanad, and this Venice of East, people own their own boats. People from different parts of the state, different parts of the country, different parts of the world gathered here to witness the sports of the battle in this backwaters of Alleppey. Now you can see the heat number 5. There was some starting foul, so they are going to restart the heat number 5. Unlike in the other heats, there are 4 boats in this heat. Altogether, there are 20 snake boats are participating in the competition. Track number 1, Karuvatta Chundan. Track number 2, Sri Ganeshan. Track number 3, Mahadevan. And track number 4, Jawahar Tayangiri. They are eagerly waiting for the kickoff of the heat number 5. Karuvatta Chundan is with Vembanad Boat Club, and Sri Ganeshan is under Lourdes Mada Boat Club. Mahadevan is under VBC Boat Club, and Jawahar Tayangiri is under Navajivan Boat Club. So all these 4 boats are going to try their best to reach in the finals. Sometimes back there was a starting foul, so they have to restart the heat number 5. So the people are eagerly waiting to witness the heat number 5. Now we are witnessing the 67th edition of Nehru Trophy Boat Race. And this year, with some changes, the Champions Boat League, to get a sporty culture, they have started this Champions Boat League, similar to the IPL or ISL. This year onwards is Champions Boat League 2. So the 9 boats out of the 20 snake boats are participating in CBL as well. Let's hope from next year onwards there will be more boats in CBL category as well. The referee is giving the instructions to the boats about to begin the heat number 5. Sometimes back, Honorable Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan and Sachin Tendulkar, the Master Blaster, inaugurated the 67th edition of the Nehru Trophy Boat Race. This was supposed to happen on the second Saturday of August, but due to the natural calamities, has been postponed. Yes, the heat number 5 has started. There are 4 boats in this heat. The Karuvata Chundan under track number 1, Sri Ganeshan on track number 2, Mahadevan track number 3, Jawahar Tayangiri track number 4. So Jawahar Tayangiri is taking the lead in the initial stages. The register number of 2 moving in track number 4. It's almost 1.4 kilometer length for this racing track. All the 4 boats are fighting each other to reach the destination in the lowest possible time so that they can reach into the finals of this great, great, greatest water festival, water sport. In track number 1, Karuvata Chundan, track number 2, Sri Ganeshan, track number 3, Mahadevan, and track number 4 is Jawahar Tayangiri. We cannot predict who is going to be the winner in this heat because all of them are fighting equally well. So they want to reach in minimum time, and only the top 4 teams will reach into the finals. Track number 1, Karuvata Chundan, and the boat club is Vembanad Jr. and Aran Mula Parthasarathi. Track number 2 is Sri Ganeshan. The boat club is Ludhmada Boat Club Chennangiri. Track number 3, Mahadevan, is boat club is VBC Boat Club Venatugada. And track number 4, Jawahar Tayangiri under Navajeevan Boat Club Arpukkara Kottayam. The 4 boats are participating or fighting in this heat number 5. And like in the first 4 heats, there were 3 boats, but in heat number 5 and 6, there will be 4 boats. You can see the track number 1, it's Karuvata Chundan, track number 2, Sri Ganeshan, track number 3, Mahadevan, and track number 4, Jawahar Tayangiri. The energy, the rhythm, the enthusiasm of the old man is awesome. Number 22nd, Sri Ganeshan is in track number 2. But we can see this Jawahar Tayangiri is also in the top. Yes, Jawahar Tayangiri, which is in the track number 4, is leading at this point of time. But we cannot predict that they will be reaching there first because time is still with them. So the rhythm, that energy, enthusiasm, which is transforming into an action, that is going to determine the passion, that is going to determine the winner. Yes, Jawahar Tayangiri in track number 4 is leading. Yes, Jawahar Tayangiri is leading in track number 4 and track number 3, Mahadevan, track number 2, Sri Ganeshan, and track number 1 is Karuvata Chundan. But the 100 people are putting their effort in the single boat to reach the destination in the minimum time. to be the winner. Yes, track number 4, Jawahar Tayangiri is leading. They are far ahead of their competition. Let's hope that they will reach the destination, the final finishing point, least possible time. Yes, they are much ahead. They are far ahead of other teams. Track number 4, Jawahar Tayangiri is leading in front. We cannot, at this point of time, we can't see even the track number 1, 2 and 3 in this picture, because Jawahar Tayangiri is far ahead. By beating the competition, they have reached, yes, they have reached the finishing point. Jawahar Tayangiri in heat number 5 has reached the destination or the finishing line. Still there is a race for the second place in the heat number 5. Because the team which is reaching the finishing point lowest possible time will reach into the finals. Track number 3 and 2, Sri Ganeshan and Mahadevan are fighting to reach the second position in heat number 5. Yes, Mahadevan from track number 3 is leading now. They have reached the second position of heat number 5. There is one more heat is pending, and snake boat race. 4 boats will be there and it will start soon. Let's listen to Professor Cherian Alexander for the heat number 6.
Thank you, Vivek. The event now finished is heats number 5. In heats number 5, Jawahar Tayangiri, named after Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and owned by Navajivan Boat Club Arpukara Kottayam with James Kutty Jacob as captain, has emerged first, followed by Mahadevan, which owed in track number 3 of BBC Boat Club Venatagadu with Vivekanandan as captain, and the third place was bagged by Sri Ganeshan, which owed in the second track, and Sri Ganeshan was winner in the Nehru Trophy boat race in the years 2012 and 13. It was owned by Lourdes Mata Boat Club with Father Philippos as the captain, but it has to be content with the third place in heat number 5 this time. Now the heats about to take place is the 6th heats in the snake boat section, and the boats participating are Valiya Divanji, Vellangulangara, Sri Vinayagan and Ayaparambu Pandi. These are also famous names in the snake boat races, and it should be remembered that Vallangali or boat race tests the grit and the fitness of the teams which are competing here. The boats vary in sizes, designs and capacity of the rowers that it can carry, and there are also different styles of oaring. The Kuttanadan style is different from the Kottayam style, which is different from the style of the people from Kochi. It is also different from the oarsmen coming from Kollam. Anyway, all these talents are displayed at the greatest show on water, that is the Nehru Trophy boat race at Punnamada Lake, Alappuzha. See the jam-packed crowd waiting for the 6th heats in the snake boat section to commence. People of Kuttanad, whether it is rain or shine, they will be on the banks of Punnamada Lake. And Doordarshan is making hectic activity to take the live telecast of the event to 64 countries, including Commonwealth countries. So Ayaparambu Pandi sorry, Ayaparambu Valiya Divanji. It was the name earlier. It is the first monument in the memory of Raja Keshavadas, the architect of Alappuzha. Valiya Divanji. Raja Keshavadasan was called like that, and he was the architect of Alappuzha. And Valiya Divanji snake boat was built by Nedumudi Karakar in 1925. After 20 years, NSS Karayogam bought it, and thenceforth Valiya Divanji came to be known as Ayaparambu. And now Valiya Divanji, this time, see, the VIP pavilion, Sachin Tendulkar, the master blatter, the cricket legend, he is there, and he is taking a round in a boat to wave to the spectators. And some of them have come not only to see the boat race, but also to see their hero, the cricket legend. See how cordial and how clubbable he is when he is at Putnamada to witness the greatest show on water. Yes, the sixth heat has started. Valiya Divanji, owed by Civil Service Boat Club, and the captain is the ADM of Alappuzha. And you know, Valiya Divanji is named after Raja Keshavadasan, the architect of Alappuzha. And then it should be remembered that in the second track, Vellangulangara emerged winner in the Nehru Trophy boat race in the years 1988 and 2002. And in the third track, number 10, Sri Vinayagan. And in the fourth track, number 14, Ayaparambu Pandi. So these boats are also famous names in the boat races here. So it will be a good fight in the sixth heats of the snake boat section. And then Ayaparambu Pandi, it was the desire of the people of Ayaparambu to participate in their own boat at the Nehru Trophy boat race that Ayaparambu Pandi was born, incurring an expenditure of several lakhs. It was Krishnakutty Ajari who built the boat. The boat is owned by more than 300 shareholders. So this year, Ayaparambu Pandi, the race number 14, oaring in the fourth track, is owed by Punnavada Boat Club, and the captain is Thomas Joseph, the municipal chairman of Alappuzha. So if Valiya Divanji's captain is the administrative district magistrate or the ADM of Alappuzha, Ayaparambu Pandi's captain is the chairman of Alappuzha municipality, Sri Thomas Joseph. And then Sri Vinayagan's captain is Jose Thomas Choice House Kumbalam, and the captain of Vellangulangara boat is KG Madhusudanan Kavalakkal Chira. And Valiya Divanji's captain is ADM Alappuzha. Valiya Divanji's club name is Civil Service Boat Club. Vellangulangara is owned by Nedumudi Friends Boat Club, Sri Vinayagan by Cochin Boat Club, and Ayaparambu Pandi by Punnamada Boat Club. So it seems that Ayaparambu Pandi, overing in the fourth track, which belongs to Punnamada Boat Club, and with Thomas Joseph, the municipal chairman, as the captain, is slightly ahead. And then Valiya Divanji in the first track, with the ADM captain, is lagging a bit behind. But there is much distance to be covered. It seems that the track is laid from east to west, and the length of the track is 1150 meters. And people will be surprised to know that at times the boats take only 4 minutes or slightly more than that to finish off this distance. and this is the greatest team sport. Nearly 100 oarsmen are there in a snake boat. There are helmsmen, or there are nilakkar or amarakkar, and vanjipattu in the olden days was also a part of the boat race. Now also in some boats there are singers, and there are also drum beaters, and see, even music is provided by simple type of what you call musical instrument. So see the sight, the beautiful picturesque Punnamada lake is all smiles now. Rain has stopped, and Ayaparambu Pandi, it seems, is having a comfortable lead now. See, splashing waves, style of oarsmen. Now they are right to left, left to right, and the styles are different for people coming from different parts of Kerala. And the boat race is something which has grabbed a place in the international tourism map. And in this heat, that is heat number 6,